Hi everybody, welcome to our new video. Today we're going to learn something a little bit new. We want to start to show you how to create a new project in Django using what Kali Linux. So I expect that you know how to install Django. Also you know how to install what they call Python. So if you're using the latest version of Kali Linux, you are lucky that you have already those tools. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna go to terminal. After when you're in terminal, be sudo su, then you say enter. I put in your password. After that, then we're gonna go and we start straight away to create a project. But what I want you to do is cd to any place where you want to create your project, because you should put it in a place whereby it's easy to navigate to, especially most people you do things under documents. That's the thing I think is better for you. So navigate to that place, then you're gonna create what they call, we're gonna create directories and things like that. So I'm gonna go with documents. If you want to go to document, you say cd. I say cd to documents. Okay. Once we're in documents, you can see, you can put it anywhere you want, but I would just recommend documents because it's easy to find. So you're gonna say mkdir, which makes make directory, and say d Django projects. This is just the name of a directory, so you can do whatever you want. You can name it what you want, what you're gonna understand, and say enter. See, that directory is created already. Then you can say cd to that directory. We're gonna just copy and paste here. Say enter. Yes, we're in there. So now after creating that, then you're gonna say Django admin start project local what library. So this is the project we're gonna start. Inside there, you can see Django admin start project space local library. So you enter. Once you've entered, you see that worked properly. Then we have to cd to also this folder. Copy that section and say cd. Because why do I do copy? Because I avoid making some mistakes. You get me? Copy and paste. Paste there. Then you say enter. We in there. You can see things are going well now. Okay. So our current directory now, you can see we in here. You can see I created this one under documents, then we went to this, that's when where we are. So so remember that the local what library project sub direct folder is the what is the entry point. Okay, so now what we're gonna do, we're gonna go down creating local what catalog applications. So I'm gonna give you this something like here. You say Python 3 space manage.py start app catalog. Say enter. That is done. Also, whenever you do something, you can see that once you see things are going well, you just know that everything went well. Once you run the command and everything go well without no stress, then it's gonna show you. Okay. For now, we're done with that. So they say okay. Okay, so you know this catalog, well, what application is gonna live inside this folder. You can see this folder, so it should be there. Okay, so now we're gonna do something else. Okay. So you can specify your database and all that, and whatever you want to do. So, but all I did a tutorial whereby I was showing to do specify what the database. So I'm gonna show you some things. You know, when we did in that tutorial, we did the migrations and stuff. So there's something I want to do first. Let me run the server. But I'm gonna run the server, then I see if we can see something. Okay. You have 17 unapplied migrations. Okay, so we have to also do this, copy this. You must run the migration command so that you don't get into trouble or with this error. So I wanna save this error for myself here, and yeah, I'll look into it after, but that's something we should do. Remember where we started, so I'm gonna do this. I told myself I'm running the server, but now some things I have to run some things here. I can create another new tab from the present. We're gonna do this and say new tab and terminal. Okay, there's something I'm gonna show you guys. Let's see, I wanna try something before we do much of the stuff. So this is one of the things I have to do. I have to do the migrations. This command, you're gonna see it. Say Python 3 manage what, manage.py migrations. Okay, you run that. Okay, Python 3 can't open file, what. Okay, search file, the directory. I remember fixing that error before. I did use which Python. I just put Python, then cannot. Okay. What went wrong? We use the PIP something to fix that error last time. But anyway, if you find that error, let me see. I've got a tutorial on how to do that. Okay. I'm going to try to see this if it's gonna work for me. To get you and to get Google Chrome, then we see something. So since we started the server, we wanna see technically that's the way you create a new project in Django. But now there's some couple of things you have to do, though we might not do them here, but I want us to test if our Python now is working nicely. So you take let me show you. You do this, you run that, okay, then you say enter. You can see the install worked successfully. You get me? So this shows that our Python is 100% working, you can see. So so what about when we want to run the thing we claim that we did create? We can say catalog. Okay, you enter. You can see it will say 404 page not found. What do you see? Don't worry about this error. So it is expected because we don't have any pages stroke URLs defined in the what? In the catalog what you are. So what are we gonna do? So that it simply means you have managed to create a new what? A new tutorial. So now you're gonna a new project. So since this project is done, it's showing because it simply means we don't have what? Using the URL what config define in local what are URL Django tried these URLs patterns in the order admin whatever. So this since we did not create anything, this is what is something common. So you have to now learn how to create all those things. But now we've showed you how to do that. And now we're gonna focus not on this tutorial. We wanna focus on the error you saw. And one of the errors is this: when you try to migrate this, you get things like that. You get me? So once you get things like that, remember fixing that error. Let me get myself right. I did fix that error, guys. We're done with that, but I wanna see if I can show you how to fix that error. You're gonna go a bit by bit, you learn a bit by bit, you know how to run your Python now and create a new project. So what we have to know is let's go to my documents or documents and see if that project is there. You just click there. Okay, where are we going to go? Okay, look for documents. You can see Django projects, libraries, you can see catalog. You can see all of these things are created, you see. So simply means we managed to create our new project. You can see these are things we just created now. So I think that is something which is interesting to you guys and to everyone here. So now we need to know how to solve that problems. You get me? So I believe I did fix that problem in one of the tutorials, but sometimes we do a lot. Yes, I'm gonna put yes, I did create that. I'm gonna put what they call I'm gonna put the disc the video whereby I was fixing that same issue. This issue we can't what this one. So in that video you're gonna learn how to do that. And also you saw the previous error, the one I copy and paste. Also I believe I'm gonna check in one of the videos I did, then I can put it for you. Thanks guys for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. That's the way you create your new whatever, your new your new project in Django, and also to test it. It's not something difficult, and it doesn't take that longer, but the more you create, create one, delete it, create another, 3-4 times, then it's gonna stick in your head. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next video.